I got a great show lined up for us.
I've got Mr. Martin Luther
and the Pope Leo coming out.
Now, you know, Martin Luther was a priest, and the Pope was the Pope.
Without any further ado, please let Mr. Martin come out.
Yeah.
So how you been, Marty?
I've been pretty good. I mean, just a little bit of groin pain from the castration.
Yeah, I heard about that. I heard Catholic priests, you know, have to do that.
Yeah,
that's a lot of commitment, isn't it? I mean,
yeah.
I mean, like, I don't know if commitment to get married, let alone get something cut off.
Marriage isn't that bad. I mean, me and Catherine are still going strong. Even
you and your wife are so cute. I want to die.
Yeah.
Didn't you write like a book or something?
Mr. Ivy, please keep it professional.
Whatever. Sorry. Let's cut to a break. So, Mark, what was this? These ideas you had, or it was like a book you wrote or something? We never got to it.
Yes. Actually, I have it right here.
Oh, okay.
Some ideas I've written for the church and how they can change and improve.
So I guess you could say like some type of constructive criticism.
Yeah, in a way. Well, the first grudge I have against the church, they say penance can be used to justify their own righteousness. Faith alone is the connection that a person should have with God.
What?
They shouldn't try to use penance as a way to show righteousness.
Penance? Explain
to
me what that is.
It is the self-infliction of pain to justify one's righteousness.
Oh! Wait. Are you telling me I was whipping myself for no reason at all?
What?
Next question. What's another grudge you have?
Listen up, Pope, because I know you're out there. I think the church needs to do away with the punishment against sin and paying for lessened punishments. The church should have absolutely no control over that. A punishment should be between God and the person who committed the sin.
Thank you, Mark, for that amazing dictionary reading. Anyways, we'll be back shortly with the Pope. Welcome back, folks, after that short break. We've been talking to Mr. Martin Luther here about the 95 Theses and his penance. And we have to welcome out Mr. Pope Leo. Come on out. Whoa, hey, Eugene, you need to behave yourselves.
Let's start it.
Leo, we have you right to it. What is causing the depletion of the treasury?
The war with France, my lavish support of the arts, construction of St. Peter's Basilica, and finally the crusade on the Turks.
Man, that really sucks. Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, Mr. Pope, I didn't mean to use my language. Pope, Jesus.
Hey, it's okay. All you have to do...
Do not use the name of God in vain.
What?
Just pay some indulgences to forgive your sins.
Indulgences?
It's a small fine that you pay and you support, and it's forgiving your sins, and then you support the church as well. It's a win-win situation.
Man, chill out. You know I don't believe in that. It's ridiculous.
Well, we all know who the better Martin Luther is.
Weird flex, but okay.
Alright, next question. So, what is the purpose of this basilica that was built?
Well, simply, it's just a church. It's an important one because that's where I'm going to be working. And one day, I hope to make it a country.
Well, good luck with that, lol. Bless this for me.
That's not how it works.
Yeah, but paying for your sins works.
I've had enough of that lip boy.
We'll be right back after this short message.
No,
I'm putting my money on Martin.